Hey guys, how's it going? This is Nolan. I'm going to be doing a deck profile for Labrynth for the TCG because you guys are getting this deck over there really soon. It's really exciting and it's also really expensive, unfortunately. Let's do the card by card. Labrynth of the Silver Castle, we're running two copies. It's a heavy DD Crow format, so we want to make sure we always have access to one. She has three effects. First, your opponent cannot activate monster effects in response to your normal trap effects, and all of our traps are normal. Two, during your main phase, you can target a trap card in your graveyard, set it to your field. Okay? That's really good. And lastly, this is kind of the gimmick of all of the Labrynth monsters and even the spells. When one of your normal trap cards removes an opponent's monster from the field, return to hand, deck, banish, graveyard, they get an effect. Labyrinth of the Silver Castle's effect is to destroy a card on the field or a card in the hand. So it's really nice. Three copies of Labyrinth Servant Ariana. This is our starter. She can, on normal special summon, search for a Labyrinth spell or trap, which is going to be Welcome Labyrinth or Labyrinth Labyrinth. And when, again, your trap effect removes an opponent's monster from the board, you can draw a card, and then you can special summon a fiend monster or set a spell trap from your hand. You can only use one of those effects each turn. You can't use them both in one turn. Be careful of that. You don't have to special summon a monster, and you don't have to have a target. Okay? Labyrinth Stove. I think this is the best of the little, like, appliances, the furniture cards. There's a few of them. So what Labyrinth Stove does is you pitch it from hand and pitch another card from hand to set a Labyrinth Spell or Trap directly from your hand or deck. It's a quick effect, so you can do it either turn. It's a steep cost, but over the long run, when your trap removes a monster from the field, an opponent's monster, you can special summon this card. Okay, so in theory, we could activate Compulse, hit someone, and on resolution, chain link 1, 2, 3, something like that. Okay, all of your cards are gonna activate. We have three copies of Absolute King Backtrack. He's absolutely bonkers. We normal summon, go into one of our link ones, and then when he's removed from the field, or when he is sent to graveyard by any means, we can look at the top three cards of the deck and arrange them. On the opponent's turn, quick effect, any phase, we can look at the top card, flip the top card. If it's a trap, set it, you can activate it. So you can see how this card just is bonkers. You know, revealing a Sanctum or a Compulse. Also, just the way you can stack the deck is really nice. Stacking the deck without cheating is always nice. Here's our hand traps. This is going to look funny. 3 DD Crow. I think of the weak hand traps, maybe this is the best one. 3 Dimensional Fissure. This doesn't really conflict with our deck. We're trying to pull it turn one, and even if we go first, we can just yoink them with it. And it's just a turn ender. I think this is really good. I don't see where it conflicts with the deck at all, because even if we backjack and we put something in grave, we can then banish him and then activate the shifter, right? And so I think it works well, and I think this could become a real issue. We're playing a copy of Artifact Scythe. So guys, one thing I've learned from facing a lot of issues UTR elements and sprites here in Japan is our trap cards are just not trading well enough. Even D Barrier is like too slow and it's not effective enough because Splite and TR elements are playing on our turn. And D Barrier is only good for a turn. And so it's just not fast enough. I think just stopping all the extra deck is what we have to be doing here in the Labyrinth deck. So we're playing an artifact package, something we can always side out and explore other options though. Two copies of Labrynth, Labrynth. This is a really good field spell. If we have Labrynth, Labrynth up, and a monster is removed from the field via our trap effect, the opponent's field, right? We can special summon a fiend monster from hand or grave. And what this is going to give our welcome Labrynth a boost, okay? It's going to give this a bonus effect to destroy a card on the field, any card. Could even destroy your scythe that's set, right? So it's really flexible. I think two copies is good because we can search for it and we want to draw two as little as possible. Three Pot of Prosperity. This could be extravagance, but I think we're trying to find the right card instead of finding more cards right now. But I've had success either way. Called by the Grave. Three Welcome Labrynth. So this card is awesome. We special summon a Labrynth monster from deck. It's going to be Ariana or Silver Castle, okay? If we have Labrynth, Labrynth up, it also destroys a card. So in theory, if we have Labrynth, Labrynth on the field, we activate Welcome Labrynth, we special Silver Castle. She will get her effect. Okay? She will get her effect if we're destroying a monster on the field. Okay? So it's a special summon, it's a destroy, and we're triggering one of these effects as well. That's a lot of advantage. It's a very good card. It's going to be expensive. Also, if you activate a normal trap, okay, except the time this card's sent to the grave, if you activate a normal trap and this is in the graveyard, you can set this card. So even if I use this card turn one, and then, like turn three, I use a different copy, I can set this other graveyard copy. It's awesome, okay? This is a really snowbally deck. For our removal traps, we have two Compulse. I don't like putting Splites and Tiara Laments into the opponent's hands, but I like hitting extra deck monsters. I think two is okay. Three Archfiend Glitch. Target, if you control a fiend monster, target a card in the field, destroy it. Then you can send a fiend monster from your deck to the grave. That can be Backjack, it can be Ariana. It's usually Backjack, okay? This is also our Mystic Mine out, okay? So you don't see like cosmics or removal, but this is any card removal. We have two punishment, three punishments, two trap trick, three sanctums. I'm a little bit torn on trap trick sometimes, but I think we need it. I don't like being locked into one trap for the rest of the turn because often I have more than one that I want to activate and it just slows me down. So you just have to be careful with how you order it. I think this is a really good place to start for the deck, and you can adjust it, how your local meta game is going, or based on your experience in the TCG, how you feel like it's going. Side deck, it's just ideas. I think Nibiru's really good right now. Dark Ruler's good. Judgment's good because you're always going to get Even Lead or Lightning Stormed, so Judgment's good to side in going first. If you're just playing like a more rogue matchup, Ash is still really good. Maybe your Crossed Out Designator is good. You could have a Feather Duster in here as well. For the extra deck, we're gonna have two Ents for Dogmanica punishment targets, and these are all Dogmanica punishment targets pretty much. Fossil Machine Skull Wagon. So this card is you banish it from your grave, target a spell trap on the field, destroy it. Okay, pretty simple. This is our Dogmanica punishment target that gets over anything. Linkarigo, Anima, and Link Spider, just flexible ones for backjack. This, if you get, I mean, we probably shouldn't have Link Spider in here. You can put something else you like in. This Charmer, we have a lot of dark monsters, and just some utility. If you're making Cerberus, you're probably losing. I'm not gonna lie. It's like if you, I mean, I don't know. They're just Link Twos. Unicorn is gonna be our access code talker target, right? We have Ignister, Pegasus. People always freak out when this card is in the graveyard. If it's in the graveyard, you control another. And a card you control is destroyed by battle or an opponent's card effect. You can banish this card, then target a card your opponent controls, shuffle it into the deck. This could be worth playing two of, actually. Talker Goddess is my favorite extra deck card right now. And IP Mascarena. And so, this is just, a little cookie cutter, something for you to play with. This deck is really flexible. I think that's what makes it fun. Like, there's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like, you have like a 14 or 15 card core, and you have 25 cards to play around with. I would always keep it at 40. Experiment with extravagance. I don't think these cards are just are not quite good enough, I think. This card's not bad, the Fair Welcome. But we're not playing this guy. We're not playing Chandra. Like, Stove is already like steep enough cost to be pitching it and something else to just set a trap. It already feels really bad. And after a couple sets, you guys will get the new chick who's really strong. But I hope you guys enjoy the deck profile. I hope you learned something. I hope you enjoy the deck. Have fun with it. It's really cool. And have a nice day. Take care. See you guys.